All right, hello, now can you hear me, Unreal Lucid? Awesome. I'm just gonna announce real quick on Instagram that that we're live. I'm gonna go ahead and start playing. All right, sorry about that, guys. Oh, hello, Hubble Boy. And welcome, and thank you for subscribing, or following. I mean, following. So I have no short-term memory, and I was playing this last night, so give me 1 second to figure out exactly what I was working on. That was fun. So, in this game, there's Rowan's the owner of the bar or tavern, and he left some vegetables out, and his entire bar was flooded with crickets, so we had to go catch all the crickets. The point of that was to get this butterfly net or bug net. And now we can catch bees. Okay. It looks like I was gonna go make some wooden house tiles. The best part about rain in this is you don't have to water your crops today, and that takes so long. Okay, so I'm gonna remember. Eventually, you can buy the shipping catalog. You become friends with the shop owner. Not the shop owner, the other shop's owner. And then you can buy stuff from the shipping catalog, and you don't have to buy it, like, one at a time. 19, so it's 2, so 10. And we're gonna go ahead and get 20 cheap varnish, too. Eliza, she's helpful sometimes. I need house tiles, not floor tiles. So if I wanted to make floor tiles, this is how I would do it. But I don't want floor tiles, I already finished my floor. I also love the sound of the rain in this game. It's so peaceful. So there's not going to be any bees out today, which is sad. I want to catch a bee. So you got to catch a queen bee, and then the queen bee attracts all the other bees. My trees that I'm growing. So the way this game starts is you inherit this farm, and this building over here is actually the farm. It's supposed to be a bee house, but it's really run down when you get it, and really early in the game, you get given a cow. So, in every other time I play the game, I've went ahead and I've built a barn for the cow, and then I've just modified this to however I wanted it later. But I actually realized that I can modify this and make it into a pretty satisfying barn. And in this game, you have sheep, cow, chicken, and pig. Yeah, moo. Actually, I need milk. I need to milk her to make more money. So, eventually you start making recipes, but since I'm so early on and I only have 6,000 petals, which is the currency in this game, I don't have enough money to buy the different stations that I would need in order to produce food. So right now what I'm doing is I'm just, you know, gathering food and selling it to the merchants in town to make money. Also growing, of course. So I'm actually going to plant some seeds now and take advantage of this rain. Whoops. I meant to start a new line for that one. Yeah, it's okay. So these are my, it's either sugar beet or beetroot. And then this is all cucumber that I just planted with cabbage. And then over here, this is where I plant my miscellaneous seeds. So, when you use this, and you cut any of these, you get something called mixed seeds. Like what I just got. And then you have no idea what it is, so you just plant that and see what happens. There's a 1 in 4 chance that it's gonna die, because, as this shelf shows, it varies whether or not the, plant can be planted in which season. Right now it's spring, so I can't plant my blackberry bushes or my sugar beet. That's actually not sugar beet, that must be beetroot. Where did that go? When he picks up something, the thing disappears. Hey. So splat is cow poop. And why am I picking up cow poop and storing it on a shelf, you might ask? Well, you turn it into manure. And then something that I recently learned is you can actually combine these acorns and manure, and then you can replant these regular trees, and therefore you'll never run out of wood. Because the trees don't regenerate on their own in this game. So this is what I've done so far with it. I have two fields. No torches. It's a little bit of an upkeep on some of the areas, as you can tell. Because if you don't use it, it returns back to normal, untilled soil. Which is fine. I'm being picky this time around. So there was a tree here. So it was just a piece of wood there, so I'm gonna place it with some dirt. And then eventually I'm gonna clear the rest of this yard. And I'm probably gonna put an orchard down here for all of my fruit trees. So this is my house. It doesn't have a roof yet. I'm still working on it. This is gonna be my, like, workshop. I have to make some more cobblestone flooring for it, and this is where I have the carving station and the combine station. The reason I bought these two stations first instead of the cooking stations is because this way I can build building materials, which are actually one of the most expensive things in the game. Something I really like about this game, honestly, is how, I was missing one floor. Okay, so I gotta make some more floor. Okay. So two things about this game. You actually do have to sleep, or eventually you will just pass out in the middle of town, and then it'll charge you a teleportation fee. That was my bathroom. And that teleportation is 5% of whatever petals you have. This is my cat. I'm not gonna wake him up. He'll be awake when I wake up in the morning, so I'm gonna go ahead and sleep. Thank you. I love this game. Oh, and you can also play with up to four people. And when you play with four people, they each get their own farm. So what this is the whole reason it forces you to sleep is it's actually how it saves the game. This game is always auto-saving. So if you don't save it every so often by sleeping, it doesn't, like, reset, and it just, you'll eventually just crash the game anyway. So this is how it saves it for you. You never have to worry about saving otherwise. It's awesome. Something is happening in the village. Oh, this is my storage. It's my kitchen. So it's not raining today, so I'm gonna have to water my crops. First, I'm gonna check on my cow. I really like this too because I was able to give her, like, an outside. I'm gonna clean up this a little bit, and I'm probably gonna relocate this pond somewhere close, maybe like over here. At some point, I just didn't buy a sponge yet. And then I'm gonna take away this fence, and then I'm gonna move that bookshelf also into the field area. Because this whole back part is gonna be fields for growing crops throughout the seasons. Where's my cat? I hear him. Now find him. So the plants turn green when they're ready to be harvested. And this water never runs out. You can put one square of water and still always have water. I keep a pond simply for aesthetic purposes. Yes. This part drives my OCD brain a little insane. When the rest of the crops have... in the mixed seeds. Because it only happens in the mixed seeds. Unless you forget to water them. Yeah. When the crops are done at different times and you have all these, like, weird gaps. Over here, I just love... like, this looks so nice to me. And then you can just do this. I forgot to water some of these, so some of them are not ready. Looks like I missed this guy yesterday. Oh no. It's dead. It's heading to the big garden in the sky. Did I milk her? Hey. Hey. You're busy. I was... go ahead and clean up some of your area a little bit more for you. Do you want more or less grass? Do I have any grass? I do. Cows are really expensive in this game. You get gifted a cow in the beginning, and that is the only reason you can afford a cow. They are 15,000 petals each. Plant will be missed. Yes. Hello. Excuse me. Oh, shit. The whole reason my channel is 18 and up is because I am incapable of censoring all the time. Has the entire yard. Is that a little cow? Oh yeah, it is a little cow. Excuse me. Thank you. Wait, didn't I just water those? Oh yeah, I just watered that side. Whoops. Oh wait. Coffee bean? Oh, that's cool. So this was one of those miscellaneous miscellaneous plants, like just one of the mixed seeds that I got. And I have never seen coffee beans, so that must have been in the latest update, because they just updated this pretty recently. My inventory is getting full. Okay, so I guess I'm gonna make a coffee field. Hell yeah. Seeds. Oh, you know what I'm gonna do? So, this is the new world that I've started, because I want to get really creative with the building and everything. But I'm actually going to show you guys one of my old world real quick, and then come back to this one and keep playing. Just because I want to show you some of the other things that are there, that are pretty cool. Are there any bad guys? Nope. It's a super peaceful game. It's awesome. You literally just go around, plant some crops, make some food, and sell it, and then buy some animals and build stuff. You get to build a museum at one point. I think... Is it this one? There's a lot of quests, like side quests, like stuff that you do for other people in the village, and then it gets you stuff. So, like, one of them is the shop owner that I mentioned earlier. If you befriend him, he's an elf. That's kind of irrelevant. But if you befriend him, then you end up getting the shipping catalog, and then you can just order stuff to be delivered to your house, and you can also sell stuff that way. And at that point, you can start making so many petals. If I'm right, this is the world that I have like 100,000 something petals in. But it was like one of my first worlds. So the reason I started a new one is because this is the one where I was like trying to figure out how to build stuff and, you know, figuring out the lay of the game and everything. So now I want to play a version when I know what I'm doing. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is the right one. So the only downside about the way the game saves is as the game gets bigger, the initial load time for the world gets a little bit longer. It also has music. I'm just not one to turn on video game music normally. Because it's normally like one step above elevator music, you know what I mean? Okay, so it's winter in this world. Okay. This is one of the bigger ones. So you make a fishing spot for one of the members of the village at one point. This is the one I made. She comes here and she fishes. She's a cat. This was the start of my orchard. none of these are producing anything right now because it's winter. And then the plan for this is for it to eventually be entirely lined with bushes all the way down. And then this is the farm. Sunflowers grow year round in this game, and they produce a good bit of money. They also yield seeds when you harvest them, so they're always a good thing to have around. Oh, something good about winter is you never have to water your crops during the winter because it's always snowing. Oh, this is my cat in this game. His name is Oliver. Okay. Is this the game where I have two? Okay, no, this is the one where I have two. So in one of the games, my brother was playing, and then he decided to stop playing, so I have two pets now. This is the shipping catalog. So I can put stuff in here, as you can see, for it to get sold. This is honey from my bees, which I'll show you. Really? They can diminish radiation levels? That's interesting. The cat can open doors, by the way. But I'll show you my bees in a second. And then I also have sheep, that's how I have wool. And then you can go here, and this has everything that you can order in the game. In multiple different categories. I am trying to remember how to scroll through. Oh. These are the machines. So I have a mod on this, but it's not really a mod because it doesn't take away your achievements or anything, but it just lets you have the auto stations, because otherwise, how you saw me making every 10 set of building tiles is how you would have to make every single item, and eventually when you're making a lot, it's just a real pain to do. So there's that. Of course, this game, I tend to save like right before nighttime. It's a bad habit. Oh, I need to sell those sunflowers. So I must have just harvested some sunflowers. No animal in this game has any concept of personal space. And this is the barn. So I never finished the roof because roof tiles are expensive and you can only build the red ones, which is kind of boring. These are my chickens. If your animals aren't happy, they won't produce anything. So you have to pet them every day. He's my favorite. This is the barn. This is the ceiling tiles that I'm working on filling the entire barn with, and then it's gonna have these red roof tiles. But these ceiling tiles are a little pricey. And then this is my house. So this is the main room. This is mostly where I store my cooking supplies. So, something that I really, really love about this game, like, it's like my favorite thing ever, and it's why I like this game over Minecraft when I am in the mood to play something to build stuff, is when you make stuff in this game, you make everything. So, like, these sugar beets, I think it's the boil station, and you boil them and turn them into sugar. And then you can combine sugar with stuff like flour, which you make from wheat. And then you can make cake. Over here, I have some of my vegetables. You can also make stuff like... Well, actually, I can just show you guys. Hang on. Okay, so you can make salad. This is all the stuff you can make in the game. Well, you have to... Okay. So you have to learn recipes in the game to get the recipes here. However, you can always just go to the Staxel wiki and see all the recipes in the game if you want. Because the recipes do cost money from the shop. But yeah, cake, you make egg, flour, butter. So if you want to make a cake, then you're going to have to figure out how to make the flour and the sugar. And then once you have the flour and the sugar... Oh, and the butter, because you got to make the butter too. And you make butter from milk to start. Like, it's super detailed. Goat cheese. I didn't know there were goats in here in this game. Now I must get a goat. And then these are all my fruits. My bushes are strawberry and blackberry bushes, and then I have cherry trees. This is my room. I went with a purple theme here, if you can't tell. This is all the cool stuff that I found along the way in the game. So, some of this stuff is like rewards for achievements from the village. And then others is stuff that realistically, like this whole shelf here, the yellow vole boy, the letter in the bottle, yeah, just those. Those are items that just kind of you pick up along the way, and it turns out that someone in the village normally has lost that item. So if you ask around, someone will be like, "Oh my god, I just lost my vole boy," and then you can give it to them. If you unfortunately though, that quest disappears after that day, so. If you don't realize that you picked it up, or you forget to go ask around the village, you're just stuck with it, and you can't sell it. So you can either, like, throw it and wait for it to despawn, or you can, put it on a shelf, and that's what I normally do. This is what I look like in this version of the game. And you can change your outfit through here. These are all my stations. And these are all auto stations, so I don't have to do anything once I put the stuff on there. And then this is my storage. I am also working on putting a roof in here. This is... this shelf is for lights. This one is unoccupied as of now. So basically, shelves are like chests in this game. They're like... they're to this game as chests are to Minecraft. They're your way of storage. Takes a little more space though, which is slightly annoying. Flooring, miscellaneous wood items, including door frames. This is roof tiles and like bricks. Down here is all the flower petals that I've gathered. It's how you can change different colors of things. They're needed in certain recipes. These crystals you get from... There's a yearly event in the village where you can teleport to 4 different realms and you can collect these crystals there. The pink ones are from the fairy realm. These are just from plants. These are sponges that are just filled with pond water and tropical water. Some more miscellaneous building supplies. An extra pair of shears, because I keep losing them somehow. And then when you start fishing, you start to pick up little animals. And you can have them. And then when you build the museum, you can go ahead and put them on display, along with all of these fossils. These are unpolished right now, because I don't have the museum in this version. It's actually in the other unsaved, or the other larger saved game. And I can show you some of those in a second. These are some more of the stuff that I've collected. So that's this world. So this is my second world. And as you something else I like is you can have the over you can look in the overhead view and you can move. So you can go nice and fast. So let me load up that other world. Actually, while that other world's loading, I'm gonna run to the bathroom. I will be right back, guys. Hello, hello.
I am back. And I have my large game loaded up. Can you guys hear my rats? They're drinking obnoxiously loud. So, remember how I said this game will knock you out? See that little notification in the bottom left? Pretty soon, I'm going to sleep. Every now and again, the game kind of blinks and you just kind of see through houses. It's fine. What are you? Oh, and when you collect, whenever you catch something, you get a little thing. You can collect everything. I'm close, but not close. I'm like halfway there. For bugs. For, how am I on fish? I have like no fish. I'm not doing bad on fossils. I'm almost done my fossils. And got a few paintings. So watermelon, blueberries, cocoa, strawberries, tomato, empty jars, cucumber, pumpkin scythe. When it comes to Halloween time in the game, you can go through a maze, you can get a. Right? At least you can make one here. And I do have one actually. Where is it? Right there. My fishing rod. Or no, actually, you have to buy all of your tools in this game. It's the only downside. But what you can do to them is you can upgrade them. So these are hardened. That's why they're blue instead of how they're green in the other one. And that just means they can do a farther. Well, with the watering can, it means that it can hold more water. With the scythe and the shovel and the pickaxe, it means it can do more at one time. Because you can scythe like four or five different blocks at once with a regular one, and then you can scythe even further with the other. Got a dragonfly. Can you chill? What is this? Excuse me. Hi. I saw you fires. Like? Hello, Presto. Oh, these are the fine wares. Some popsicles. So what's also fun about this game too is like, even though you make all this food, you don't have to eat. You can if you want to. When this guy comes to town. Talk to me. Eh. I forget what his encyclopedia points are for. But whenever you find anything new, you go to him and you tell him, and he gives you encyc. Oh. Remember what I said? I went to sleep. Oh man, did I wake up? Am I waking up in the field in the rain? Yep. Okay. So, how about before that happens again, I find my house? Because you see the Z's up in the top corner? So what happens, actually, I was wrong, I forgot. It isn't. don't take teleportation points from you, but they do just knock you out. And then it progressively becomes less and less time until you fall asleep again. So I had a friend working on this house in this world with me as well. So this is their house. And I think I may have snapped the bed from this already. Just kind of inconvenient. Yeah. Wonderful. Okay. That also means my house is on the other side. You know what? This is one of those cases. Teleport home. I'm going to get some sleep, and then when I wake up, I will show you guys around. Oh, I can't sleep. Never mind, it's daytime. Okay, you guys want to check around? So again, this is my shelf of things. I just have a lot more this time. This is all wardrobe items. This is my chest. It's just decorative. This is my desk. I'm working on building an office here. I'm collecting all of the different grass because I wasn't for a while, and then there's a certain point where I decided that I wanted to decorate my lawn a different color and draw like patterns in the grass using the, you know. Oh, I forgot to mention this. Really? Apparently it's storming like on the whole like south of the US right now. It's kind of gray outside too here, so might start storming here a bit. But anyway, this is so cool. So the pets bring you stuff, and they're all shaped like paws, and they're cute. So they've brought me a love seat and some tables, a chair, a bigger table, this other chair. Is there a snowball? This is Winfred. This is the one where I have two. That's not a bug. That's Winfred. This is snowball. This is kind of like, it's gonna be like my like reading space or potion space. These are kind of cool. So these are transformation potions, and it just lets you look like another person in the village for a week. Or not a week, it's like a day. What am I talking about? My farm license. And my friend's farm license. And my brother's. And then again, this is another version of that storage room. I also have some paintings in here. I also have the Seed Reaper, and basically what that lets you do is it lets you put like harvest plants in there. Like I could put these cucumbers in there and it'll spit out seeds, and sometimes you get these golden seeds, and the golden seeds actually produce plants that are more valuable, so you want to try to get them. And then recipes including the golden seeds are also more valuable. And here I have, so it's the wrong time of year to plant this stuff, that's why it's all in here. These are all my vegetables. So I always chop them, because whenever you use them for recipes, you need to chop them anyway, so I just chop them when I harvest them.
And this is all of my ingredients up to here. I have some rice. So, milk. Milk is one of the most important things in this game, and you also only get one per day per cow. And cows are 15,000 petals. So I think I have like 9 cows in this game. The inconvenient thing is the reason why milk is so important? Well, because you need milk to make cream and butter, which are included in most recipes. So then I have some more of these crystals and everything, and all my building supplies. As you can see, I've been building a lot in this version of the game, so I have a lot of building supplies. And let's go ahead and check out the town. Well, actually, first let me show you my farm. Okay. So this is an overhead. She's kind of kooky. You find her, like, stuck in a tree, and you help her out. This is sugarcane. Looks like it's actually ready to be harvested, so I'll go ahead and collect some of it while I'm here. Milk. Got milk. Calcium. I learned that the whole thing about, like, I don't remember why, because there has to be, like, a reason. It's probably capitalism. But, the whole, like, milk being super good for you is mostly propaganda. Because it's actually, like, not as good. And pure milk doesn't even have calcium, which is the thing that everyone promotes. Or everyone thinks milk is so good for. Or no, it's vitamin D. Sorry. Vitamin D is what milk doesn't naturally come with. Our milk's fortified with it. Humans are also one of the only species that drinks the milk of other animals. So I can actually show you guys. Oop. Wait a minute. I have too many rooms. Okay. I'm gonna plant these tomatoes. So, I think it's boil. Yeah. So, you boil the sugar cane. To make sugar. Since it's raining, I'm gonna go ahead and plant these. It wasn't raining on me. Wasn't going to because I... Oh, that's why I can't plant them. Only a summertime plant. That eggplant. Frozen autumn. Let's go. Interesting how it's raining in the real world a lot right now, and it's raining in the game. Why do I have so many egg patch, you might ask? Money. Because what I'd like to set up eventually
essentially it's a permanent field of rotating crops that have the auto waterers on them. And I can just go post. I'll check every day to make sure that they're not ready to be harvested. These are fairy trees. And this is my garden. Welcome to all of my cows. I'm also actually going to plant this golden eggplant too, just to see what comes out. Oh, that's cool. It actually even is golden. Alright, it is nighttime. I sleep as early as I can in this game because I'm impatient and it starts to get dark and hard to see. You know, that's something that I never thought about. This game's so, like, accurate with everything else. I wonder if, oh, these are fairy houses. I wonder if, they actually, like, put a timing between the thunder and everything. And then if you travel farther away, if it... So, let's find some of the houses I've built. Here's one. Well, okay. Hers is not done, actually. Hers is the one I'm currently building. Although she seems... It has enough... It has everything for her to live in it. I just, you know, want to give her a roof. Even though she doesn't care. Here's another one that I was working on. Just leave some shit on their table. So it's farm fans. I think this is Oscar's. This is gonna be for their walkway. It's gonna be an extension of this cobblestone path. So this is the building's old lady's house. Can't it comes in the game. The shop like normal. Oh, I haven't shown you the shop. Welcome to my museum. So I got some displays. These are mostly empty. Yeah. I'm gonna be a chat about it and I'm gonna leave that there actually. And welcome to my fossil collection. So you get them, each of these like little squares is a fossil that you find, so you have to get them and then put them. This is one of my favorite parts of the game. Honestly. It's like archaeology. I am an archaeologist at heart. As you can see, I am missing the head of this one. Fossil right there, watch up ahead. I'm still actually harvesting. This is my fossil polisher. This is my fossil storage for duplicates. This is where you sell your items before you have the shipping catalog. I'm trying to find, there's a bakery that I also think I made. So this is the baker's house. However, I wanted to do something kind of cool, which would be something that I would kind of like if I owned a business. This is her house, and right here, through a nice and secure closed storage area, she can enter her bakery. Go ahead and leave shit. And that's all I had to show you guys in this world. So now I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna go back to the one where we're working on stuff. The most recent world, the first one that I was in. And we're gonna try to get to this point in that world.
Just one second.
Excuse me, you guys, I'm sorry. She's positively glowing with light. Aww. It is the 16th of spring. Oh, it's the Fae Masquerade. You guys are about to see the Fae Masquerade. First, let me get rid of this shit. Because I want to get some stuff from there. Oh, I can buy another bookshelf. What am I doing? Oh no, I was going to build another bookshelf, that's why. And I'm just going to put... Yeah, I'll just sell some stuff. I have the game to set. I have the game set to load like this. It helps the game just like load faster. Okay. Oh, I was selling stuff. I need to go to them. I love that. Lego Master. So I'm building like, I didn't feel like doing it today. And my hand is also not super happy with me. But I'm building a little fridge. So I'm actually building a tiny house. And it came from one of those, like, you know, tiny house kits that you can, like, buy on Amazon. And I really like it. But. It's designed for you to, glue everything down. And that's boring. Or at least to me, boring. My roommate really enjoyed it. She glued everything down. And, you know, that's her choice, but... I wanted to make it so that it's interactive, so that I can like move around the house and like change around the bedrooms if I want. Well, maybe not change around the bedrooms because I'm actually doing like flooring and wall paneling and stuff. But the way it comes, you're just supposed to. It's got glue on wallpaper and like glue on floors. And you're supposed to glue everything together. And I didn't want to do that. So I had my roommate 3D print me some floor tiles. And I'm using popsicle sticks. and I'm modifying it how I'd like. So the fridge comes as basically a box that doesn't have a back or a bottom, and you're supposed to like glue it up against the floor and the wall. And then the front is a flat side that you're supposed to glue two square pieces on to make it look like a door. I decided I want a real fridge. So I took that and I'm turning it around. So the part that was supposed to be the front of the fridge is now the back, and the front is open. And what I'm making is I'm making little shelves in there. I'm making a freezer and fridge section. I'm making some veggie bins, and then I'm going to make doors. And then from there, I'm going to make little tiny food items to stick inside. It's just going to be a really long-term project for the house because of how in-depth I'm doing it and how many other responsibilities I also have. I'm organizing my inventory really quickly to make it easier for selling items. Why do you have a bunch of sand and rocks in your inventory? Well, that's how you make a cobblestone path. And as tempting as it is to sell this dirt, I'm not going to because it unfortunately does come in handy. And it comes in handy to have both a pile of dirt and a pile of grass. Now, if you run out of... the only reason I keep a pile of grass is because you normally have a lot less grass than dirt. But you can also just turn grass into dirt. Okay, so that's all sold and done. Where's the fae? There it is! Okay. Alright, guys. I'm never successful at this, and it's almost over already, and that's why I'm never successful. Hello. Sure. No! Damn, okay. Me, I can help out. Here's a list of like 20 rooms. Oh boy. Okay. I think I caught a fairy. Okay, no, I didn't catch any fairies. Okay. see what's missing. Oh, here. One large fey table. Where am I supposed to find that? Much, but two-faced sofa. Fey glass table. Is that supposed to be in there? Oops. So I think what I have to do is I just have to wander around the house and find what's out of place. And it would be really nice if I had a magnifying glass. Just guess, but anything that's out of place is just gonna literally just be in some weird place. Toufey armchairs are missing. So where would all of this be? Like, it's like there's three missing sofas in this whole place. Like, where? This part's always hard too, because they don't really give you much. However, it is fun to navigate this because it gives you an idea on how to build like a really nice, like, three high structure. Fake coffee table. Hey. This belongs somewhere. Table. However, I think we're at the top. This is missing. Lamp. Hmm. let me go get another face. Let me go get that face over back, because hold up. I'd rather get at least one room done. Pardon my language, y'all. I think that's all of them. Still has something missing. Oh wait, I have time. I thought the festival was about to end, so I was like trying to stay awake. Like not me, like in real life stay awake. Like it's 8 o'clock here.
Yeah, same time zone, which is kind of wild.
wonderful.
Oh, be on the lookout for glowing pink butterflies, too.
Why am I making the roof in such a terrible material, you might ask? Well, you see, these fairies aren't giving me any money. They're just like, fix my shit. For free. So we're gonna fix it. If it'll let me, with some dirt. Be on the lookout for an armchair. I think that's what we're missing. Oh geez. Okay, there we go. Cool. So like they're all just missing roof pieces. The game accepts just like a few blocks of dirt for some reason. I'll take it. I just want to see what the prize is. I'll do better next year. I know she's gonna say something about room 108, but I cannot find room 108. Thank you.
Alright, so it looks like all we have left is to find the mysterious room at 108 and find that armchair. Just teleported home before the game these are red now.
Oh, look at her, she poops outside. No. Oh, don't run away from me now. Always up in my space. I'm not ready to milk you. Okay. So first we need to go ahead and make sure that it is still... Yes! We are still in the masquerade. Which means I got some time. Let's go. Interesting. This isn't a room, is it? No. Ooh, parrots. So I've never had a parrot, but my grandmother had a mockingbird, and I didn't know the mockingbird. But she said it used to torture the dog. It would be like, it'd be like, go outside, and then dog would be like, yeah, we'll go outside, and it would like run to the door. It was so funny. The totem. Okay, so we were in the wrong place. Apparently, this room's outside because why not? It's this. I was right. Okay, so it just needs a sofa. And what? A lamp. And then we're done. Well, sort of. I need to find that armrest still. Oh, and a sofa. Well. See, I don't want to look up the things we couldn't find, but I wanted to, at least find the room, you know? Okay, so let's think. There's a giant tree outside, right? That's all I need. I need a couch, it looks, I think. Is that it? So we need the face sofa. Then I think this room needs an armchair. Yeah, this is the one with the that I need armchairs for. So I need to get up all the way to the top.
Ah.
$108 needs a couch. Gotta find a couch. This is supposed to have two. Aha! Oh, and the cool part about this is it comes back every year, so I found all the items, and this year I can, next year I can make it all pretty. So for that, I got a fairy headband and a flower watering can instead of my regular water can. Okay. Wait, does it do anything different or is it just a watering can? Yep, no, it's just a watering can. Okay. Alright, so now it's soap. Catch some fairies. I think I caught one. Nope. So this part's really hard. You kind of just gotta wander around town until you find some butterflies that are like glowing. I don't think these are normally fairies. Fireflies. Where did what I just caught go? I swear that thing I caught, or the thing I swatted at, that like disappeared? That was so a fairy. Let me just see if the game glitched. So the fairies are gonna be. They have blue ones too. Because I was blue. So something that you guys might find is either cool or really annoying, depending on how you're feeling.
Queen bee.
So I can have honey now. It is, things never spawn in the same place. Unless they're, like, standard items. But, like, these butterflies, they're just gonna spawn above wildflowers. You gotta keep looking. It's apparently blue or just regular fairies. Pink or bad fairies. Or mischievous fairies. Look at all these fossils. Probably gonna finish out this fairy festival and then hop off for the night. Unless I can't sleep, and then I'll be back. This guy's coming handy. More bees! Okay, so basically my inventory is full. So I need to go sell some bugs. I really like this game. It's kind of like, for me it's... A lot of people describe it as Stardew Valley, but I never played Stardew Valley. So to me, it's just kind of like if Minecraft and Farmville had a baby. So I can't give away this butterfly. That's so weird. The museum guy. Well, that was cool. It's like the game wouldn't let me sell them.
thought I collected a lot more bugs. Alright, let's focus. Just find me a fairy. Oh my gosh. My bug net. Okay, this is my, I will grab this when I go back home pile. Because I want to have enough inventory for cool stuff. Wait, I need that. Oh yeah, definitely, because they're so, like, especially, like, outside. So, like, that's something I really like about this game, too. Like, because it's so, because of the sound and just everything about it, if you're having, like, a bad day or anything, you can kind of just play this game and pretend, like, you're in this, like, little peaceful world full of birds and butterflies and random fossils on the ground. And men that come out of butterflies, because why not? You a regular butterfly? Yep.
Okay, I don't think it'll be this far away from town. These mischievous fairies really are not interested in being found. Which sounds like a mischievous fairy, honestly. Oh, something else cool about the game is you start out with different town members, like, every time. And the different town members help you with different things. Like, they're the same, like, you know, anyone who's, like, a main character that you interact with. In the very beginning, like, the, I thought my floor was on fire, and I was like, when did they add that? Like, the people in the buildings and the shops. Shop people, especially. Farm fan. A few of those people are, like, the mayor. But, like, just regular residents in the town change. Today is the last day of the festival.
to do this before I go head out looking for fairies, because I forgot to do it yesterday. A few of them are heading to the garden in the sky.
I wish I could find a fairy.
Like this
There's actually a quest later in the game where Oscar, the one with the broom who's coming around town, he asks you to help clean up stuff around town, and all of a sudden there's all this trash just everywhere that you like you could never see before. So it's not looking promising on finding fairies before this quest is over. We still got a few in-game hours. Hey, and I have a place for my bees.
Wait, there's no flowers up here, so they will not be up here. Alright, so it's about to be nighttime in the game, so I'm gonna go ahead and call it. Gonna go ahead and get back to my house real quick. All right, well, it was nice, and have a good night.